Now we turn to the other attribute of Allah, which is Al-Khabeer, which means to be aware. Al-Khabeer, which is coming from Khabar. Khabar is the news. Al-Khabeer, the person who got the news, the person who knows everything. وَلِلَّهِ مِيرَاسُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. And to Allah belongs the inheritance of the heaven and the earth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully aware of whatever you do. عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ. He is the one who knows what is unseen and what is present, and he is wise, he is aware of everything. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِعِبَادِهِ لَخَبِيرٌ بَصِيرٌ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well aware of the needs of his people, and he sees them as well. And we can see that another ayah of Al-Quran where Al-Alim Al-Khabir is mentioned, that is the case of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when secretly he told something to one of his wives. Now she revealed it to someone else. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam what happened. This is what is mentioned in Surah Al-Tahrim. وَإِذْ أَصَرَّ النَّبِيُّ إِلَىٰ بَعْضِ أَزْوَاجِهِ حَدِيثًا فَلَمَّا نَبَّعَتْ بِهِ وَأَذْحَرَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ أَرَّفَ بَعْضَهُ وَأَعْرَضَ عَنْ بَعْضٍ فَلَمَّا نَبَّأَهَا بِهِ قَالَتْ مَنْ أَنْبَأَكَ هَذَا قَالَ نَبَّأَنِيَ الْعَلِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam secretly said something to one of his wives, and she disclosed it to someone else, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that the secret has been disclosed. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke to his wife, arrafa ba'dahu wa a'rada an ba'd, and he disclosed few things, did not disclose the other thing. When he told him the whole story, she was totally wondering, who told you? That is the question she said. قَالَتْ مَنْ أَنْبَأَكَ هَذَا. Who told you? And he is saying, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, قَالَ نَبَّأَنِيَ الْعَلِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ. Allah who is Alim, who is Khabir, he told me. This is the attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he knows and he is also aware of whatever is happening in this world. And then anything which is hidden, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it. Anything which is done in a closed room, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows those sins which are committed by the human beings. وَكَفَى بِرَبِّكَ بِذُنُوبِ عِبَادِهِ خَبِيرًا بَصِيرًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there to know all the sins of his servants. He is fully aware of them and he knows them. And this implies that we human being, whenever we commit a sin, we should always realize and remember that there is someone who is watching us. So this is why we should try to abstain from committing the sin. And we said in a previous episode about this ayah of Surah Luqman, in which Allah has said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَ وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْسِ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدَى وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. And we have explained at that time that what does it mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala got the knowledge of the last hour. He brings the rain down. No nafs knows what it is going to earn tomorrow. No nafs knows in which part of the earth it is going to die. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything and he is aware of everything. That is a great ayah of Al-Quran, which shows that as far as the knowledge of the human beings are concerned, it is based upon some conjectures, some signs. Some people, they say that now our scientists can predict about the rain. When the rain is going to come, they can predict about it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what He is saying here, وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثِ, He is the one who brings down the rain. Here it is not saying that the knowledge of the rain is with Allah. No, the wording is different. He is the one who brings down the rain. This is not in the hand of the human being. So we should try to understand what this ayah means. And with this, we come to the end of this session. And inshallah, we are going to continue after the break. And we will take two more attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.